So today we will be discussing hard problem 440, kth smallest in lexicographical order. So let's first understand the problem statement. Given two integers n and k, return kth lexicographically smallest integer in range 1 to n. Okay. So the problem is saying that we have given two integers n and k, and in range n 1 to n, we need to find the kth lexicographical number. So here lexicographically not mean like 1, 2 or 3. Here they by lexicographical they mean like 1 and then 10, because after 1 is there is 0. So they are seeing by digits and then by length and then like 100 and then let's say 1000 and so on. So this is what the problem statement is saying. So if let's say k is equal to 3, then we say the answer is 100. So let's first understand what the problem intuition is. Let's first understand how we are going to solve this problem. So let's take this example. Let's say n is equal to 13 and k is equal to 4. So it would be 1, 10, 100. It's n equal to 13. So 1, 10. Now it would be 11, then 12, then 13. Okay. So in this we can see that so what the intuition is that we say find all the numbers from 1 to 13, find all the numbers which have prefix as 1. So like these are all the numbers with prefix as 1, and after 13 the 2 will come, and then it would be 3. So we didn't put 20 here because n is 13, so all numbers should be smaller than equal to 13. So first we say find all the numbers with prefix 1, and we try to see if k is smaller than the total number with prefix as 1. Why? So let's say like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here are 5 number with prefix as 1. So we know that k must lie in between here since k is 4. Why should we look here? So it's unnecessary to look here. We just say fix 1 as a prefix, because since k is lie between here, so it lies in the count of prefix with 1. So we fix prefix as 1 and we say now find what should come at this place. So we fix 1 as the prefix. Now we are finding the second digit of the prefix, and for that we first subtract 1 from the k, because we have already fixed 1 as a prefix. Now we say for second find if 10 is the prefix or not. So how many numbers are there which is in the range 1 to 13 which have prefix as 10? There is only one number, and k is now 3 after we fixed 1. Now k is 3, so we see that k is greater than 10. So we know that k must lie outside 10, so we don't take or we don't fix 10 as prefix, and we say that k must lie outside it. So instead of fixing 0 here, we say it C for 11, because there is no because k is greater than the count of numbers with prefix 10, and when it sees for 11, and also since one we have decreased one number, now the k would be 2. And now we see for 11 we also find out that no, 11 cannot also because k is 2 and numbers from 1 to 13 there is only one number which is 11. So k is greater than, so k must lie outside this. So we see for 12, and when we are seeing for 12, since we remove this 11, we say now k is 1, and since now k is 1, so we know it is now 12 must be the answer. So we say fix 2 here, and now we make it 0, and since k is 0, we return 12 as the answer. So so main idea is to just find how many prefix are there with this, how many number are there with this as its prefix, and if k lies in between them, we fix that number as prefix for k, because that must occur as a prefix in k, since we fixed 1 and now 1 can 1 is coming in its prefix of k, we fixed 12 and 12 is also coming as a prefix of k, and if k lie outside, we see for next number. We see so let's say if k would does not come in for prefix of 1, so what would we have done? We have increment 1 and we will see for 2. Why? Because since k will not have prefix as 1, because there are only 1 2 3 4 5 numbers with prefix 1, and if k is equal to let's say 6, so we know since k is greater than the count of number with prefix 1, k would not have prefix as 1. We remove all these number from the k and make it 1, and we now start to find how many numbers are there with prefix as 2. So let's see the implementation. I am going to make this as a recursive function. So I am initializing here a variable prefix which would be the prefix of the numbers we have found out till now, and I'm initializing it as 0, because in start we won't provide it any value and we want it as 0, and now we iterate from I equal to, now here we would be iterating from 1 to 9. So what I did here is in start we would be iterating from 1 to 9, but in other cases let's say we have fixed a prefix as 1, now we would be iterating from 0 till 9, 19. So since 1 is fixed, so we have to iterate from 0 to 9, and in that case we would have been providing a prefix greater than 0, but in start we only want it to iterate from 1 to 9, that's why I initialize it as 0, and if this is 0 we start from 1, and if it is not 0 then we start from 0. So these are actually the digits we are seeing for whom we are seeing as a if this could be fixed as a prefix. So let's see, so let's first see how many numbers have prefix n, prefix I but less than n, and let's say this function will give us the prefix, this count function will give us the prefix where prefix into 10 plus I. So we would be finding how many numbers are there from 1 to 9 which has prefix as this. So in the start prefix, since prefix is 0, so we I and I is 1, so we would be finding for 1, and in later cases when prefix let's say is 1, then it would be and in start I would be 0, then we would be finding for 10. I will explain it in a minute, and we would pass n, and let's say that this variable, or we can say the numbers whose prefix is I and they are less than n, is less than equal to k, or we can say is greater than equal to k. So we know that k lies in here, so we know, since we know that k lies in this range, we say now increment the prefix. So we say that fix this prefix I, because since k lies in between here, so we fix this prefix and decrease it by 1, and we fix prefix I by saying prefix into 10 plus I. So now in place of prefix, this will go, and since we have decreased the k by 1, and we return it. And else, if k is greater than these numbers, so we know that k lies outside this range, as I explained you. When k lies outside this range, we just remove these numbers from the k, and we increment this I. And since I is in the loop, it will increment by itself. So now let's see the implementation of this count function, which is the most important thing. So the count function would give us the prefix, would give us all the number which have I as its prefix. So we say that if prefix is greater than n, so if since we have given this range, and if there some prefix come which is greater than n, we cannot take it in the counting, so we return 0. Else if prefix is equal to n, so if prefix is same as this, so we just return 1, because there is only one number with this in the range. And let's say count is equal to 1. So since this number itself is in the range, so we say we initialize the count as 1 for this. And now we are just looping until and unless we find we go out of range. So we would be maintaining actually two variables. So we would be maintaining two variables, min prefix as and its initial values would be prefix, and max prefix would also be prefix. And we would be incrementing this prefix ranges, and we will be seeing how many numbers are there. And so min prefix is equal to 10 into min prefix. So what I did here is, let's say we need to find one for one, how many number are there which have prefix as 1. So there would be so we will see from 10 to 19, and then we will see between 100 to 199, because after this there would no number till 100 to 99 which has prefix as 1. So to do this, we are maintaining these two number, min prefix and max prefix, and max prefix would be 10 into max prefix plus 9. So let's say in start the min prefix become 10 after multiplying 1 with 10, and max prefix become 9. Now if n, we did not reach n, so we find for 100, we multiply min prefix again with 10, and this will become 190, because it was 90 and plus 9, which is 199. So now we also see that if n is less than min prefix, so if we have crossed the n, we come out of range, we say break this loop, because we cannot count any more number because we are out of range. And if min prefix is less than equal to n, and n is less than equal to max prefix, so we are saying if n lies between this min prefix and max prefix, we would only be taking numbers only be taking the numbers till n. We are not taking a number from min prefix to max prefix, because n lies between these both the ranges. So we take till n minus min prefix plus 1, and we break the loop. And if we are in the range, these both number are in the range, so we would be taking the whole range. So if 100 and 199 lies in the range, we take all these number, 199 minus 100 and plus 1, because we have to take this number also. And then we just return the count. So this function is what giving us the number of prefix, number of count of numbers which have this as prefix. So we are maintaining these two numbers and we are incrementing it like this with powers of 10, and we are saying if we are out of range, break the loop, and if we are in the range, just add these ranges and return it. And since we are recursively calling it again and again, we will call it again and again until k reach 0. So if we have to also give a base case, so if k is equal to 0, so just return prefix, because that is the number we are looking for. If k is 0, there is no more digit to find. So here we would be returning, let's say, prefix, and here there's a slight problem. It should be n here, and also we have not called this number, we have not called this function. So it's looking good, so let's submit it. Okay, so this is how it's so if there is any question, any doubt you want to ask, you can ask in the comment section, and yeah, thank you very much. Thank you.